farz, sunnat, or mustahab.
Growing your beard is an obligation. It is fard, wajib, for a Muslim to grow his beard, because Prophet Muhammad ﷺ commanded Muslims to grow their beards and to trim their mustaches. And he made no exceptions in that instruction. So the only circumstance wherein one could say, I shave my beard and I feel that Allah will excuse me, is if my life or limb has been threatened. It's a question of life or death. Somebody says, either you shave your beard or I will blow your head off. You shave your beard then, that is obligatory on you. Shave your beard.
But I am very sad to look that many workers of the peace vision of Islam cutting beard, having beard very short. Why?
You'll have to ask them.
Even speakers too, and announcers and volunteers too.
Okay.
Okay, that's a good suggestion.
Let me throw something at you. Let me throw something at you real quick, okay? Just I want you to think about this. The first thing you do, you look in the Quran. It says in the Quran, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, O you who believe, obey the messenger. Okay? Obedience to the messenger is obedience to Allah. So we're going to establish that first. So if he says something, it's not like if somebody else says it. And if he tells me to do something, I need to try my best to do it or die trying. Right? All right? Yes or no? You got me? Okay. But it's not an obligation. Hold on. It's not an obligation on a man to grow his beard. And I want you to listen real close to this, because we're playing with words. Because a brother came up to me one time, and after we talked about the beard, I went through the books. They got books on this subject. And it's very clear, all four matahab. There's no excuse for you not to have a beard. They all said it. Do it. Okay? But listen, they're going to ask you about the beard in every conference you go to. They're going to ask you about the hijab everywhere you go. And they're going to ask you about riba. It's going to happen, and halal meat. I don't care where I go, I hear the same questions. But so finally, I said, listen, the first thing is the Quran. The second thing we go is the hadith. And then after that, I'm going to tell you what, just plain old Texas common knowledge, a man doesn't have the obligation to grow a beard. And I'll show you why. Because a man came to me after the conference, he said, listen, I want you to pray for me. He's a smooth face. He said, I want you to pray for me. I said, okay, what do you want me to pray for? He said, I want you to pray I'll grow my beard. I said, I can't do that. He said, why? I said, that shirk. He said, what? I said, that shirk. I can't pray for you to grow a beard. Allah is the one growing the beard. It's not your obligation to grow it. It's your obligation to stop cutting it off. I'll pray for you that you'll stop cutting off what Allah grows, but you don't know how much Allah grows. Some people don't have any beard. How could it be an obligation on somebody who doesn't have any hair coming out of their face? Your obligation is, if you get some hair, to take care of it, as the Prophet ﷺ told us about grooming it, caring for it. And it's in the madhab that when you're making wudu, that you're supposed to come up through it like this. And how are you going to do that when you ain't got nothing there to come up through? And then finally, one of the brothers who's down in Mississippi, he said, yeah, but he said, I got a problem with my wife. She wants me to be clean shaven. I said, I got to ask myself a question. What kind of woman wants her husband to look like another woman? But they never did invite me to go back to Mississippi either.